Today we have Samantha Westrich from the Greensboro office talking to us about the Proloquo2go. So take it away, Sam.
Hi, thank you, Latrell. Yes, today I will be talking about the communication app Proloquo2go. I am Sam, and I am one of the speech-language pathologists that works with the NCATP, and I am housed in the Greensboro office. So I'm going to go ahead and just share my screen. Okay. So alternative and augmentative communication, or AAC, is any device, tool, or strategy that is used when a person cannot communicate all of their thoughts, beliefs, and wants using verbal language. And this can be used by children and adults with varying abilities. And these are just some different examples of different types of AAC. So there are different levels. No tech is anything that the person can use that is on them. So facial expressions, vocalizations, gestures, sign language are examples of no tech AAC. Low tech includes communication boards or visual supports, typically things that you would think that you print out and laminate, and they do not have voice output. And then mid-tech is something that requires a battery or power source, and there is a voice output component. And they are typically what we call static display. So that means as a person is engaging with the device, the layout is not changing. They also don't have as many accessibility options. So the person typically is required to use their hand to push a button on the device. And then high tech is a device that requires a power source or has rechargeable batteries. It has what we call a dynamic display. So that's the opposite of a static display. So as the person is engaging with the device or pushing a button on the device, the display changes. It has synthesized voices. So those are voices like Siri and Alexa. So the person can really individualize a voice, and the voices are really clear, and they permit the storage and retrieval of thousands of messages in a really organized way in one device. So today we are talking about Proloquo2go, the app. So it is a communication app for people who need assistance with using verbal language. So it does have natural sounding voices, and it includes children and adult voices. And it is able to be downloaded right now only on iOS based devices. So that's the iPhone and iPod, which I'm not even sure those exist anymore, or an iPad. Proloquo2go is symbol and text based, but they do have Proloquo for text, which is for literate individuals who are just want to kind of type out a message and use speech to text. The price for Proloquo2go is $249 plus the price of the iPad or iPhone. There are different times during the year where the app is 50% off. So October was AAC Awareness Month. So they did have like a few days where the app was 50% off, and they do that multiple times throughout the year, and it's always the same month. I do caution you in just going out and purchasing a communication app. It's always good to reach out to a speech language pathologist just to kind of chat about the different features, because there are a lot of different choices out there, just to make sure that that app, before you purchase it, because they aren't cheap, is a good fit for the user. It is available in different languages, and you can use it in a bilingual way. So if somebody, you know, speak Spanish at home, but then goes to an English speaking school, there's a really easy way to kind of flip back and forth between the two different languages. But the languages available right now for Proloquo2go are English, Spanish, French, and Dutch. And then it is able to be accessed either using direct selection. So that means somebody is using their finger to poke the screen or their hand, or a stylist. switch scanning so they can use different switches, and then also the voiceover screen reader. So if somebody has some visual challenges, you can use voiceover to read the screen while you're in the communication app. So now I am going to stop sharing the slides and I am gonna demo the app for you guys. So just give me 1 second as I kind of switch screens. All right, so this is Proloquo2go. So click out and you can see the app looks like that little owl there. And again, it can be purchased in the App Store and it'll download directly onto the device. So this is a kind of the intermediate grid size. So it's a 7x7. When you create a user, it'll prompt you through to select the type of symbols and the grid size and the language. So it's really user friendly and kind of prompts you when you're first starting out. Again, highly recommend working with a speech therapist just to assist you with the setup and to make sure that you're feature matching all the different things that the user might need. So it is laid out with the focus on what we call core words. And so these are just tiny words that have a big meaning. And on the homepage, they're really easily accessible because we use them a lot. So as you're engaging with the device, you can see how it interacts like a dynamic display. So I'll just go ahead and model a sentence. So we'll say, I
want. Eight.
And then I can come down. Anything that looks like a little folder, like a little file folder, means that it'll open up. So this is where we get that dynamic display example. So I'm going to go to food and I'm going to pick cookie.
Cookie.
So once you have your sentence formed, it'll speak each word as you're selecting it, but you can also come up here and touch.
I want to eat cookie.
The tool or the speech bar, and it'll speak that whole message. So you can see as I picked the food folder, it changed and gave me options for different food. It's very able to be individualized very easily. So typically we don't recommend that you change much on this homepage as far as the layout of the pronouns and the core words. Because there is a method to the madness and it's research-based. So we like to try to keep our home screen the same. However, these little folders down here that have the categories, those can be changed to be specific to the person. So for example, going back to food here, if we know that this person is not able, you know, for whatever reason, they have an allergy or something like that, so it's not able to eat things like a hamburger, that might be something that we want to change. We always want to be careful to not restrict vocabulary from individuals. Sometimes that's a great teaching moment. If the person is to request it, we can then, you know, explain to them why they're not able to have that. But you can also organize it so that you have the things that they request the most easily accessible. So they only have to do two hits. So the quicker they can get to preferred button, the better. So if I wanted to make changes, it's really simple. I come down here to this little, pencil, and I click that there. And you navigate to the page where you want to make a change and then hit that pencil button and it puts you in edit mode. And then you just select the button that you would like to change. So for instance, hamburger. Maybe they don't like hamburgers, they like cheeseburgers. So we can come down and this opens up the edit page and you would just come in here and you can change the label. I can write cheeseburger. And then also up here is what it's gonna be speaking out. So right now it still is gonna say hamburger. So we'll wanna change that to cheeseburger. So typically we want the label to match the speech output. You can see that there's a little microphone over on the side. So you can record your voice. if you would like to. So for instance, maybe you want to do a button for singing a song and you're singing a little line like twinkle, twinkle, little star. You could, that's a fun way to kind of record a voice. Or for people, you could record them saying their name. So maybe when the user presses grandma, it says grandma's name in her voice. So just some different ways that you can kind of record voices. And then you can come down and you could pick a different picture here. So as you're typing, it's kind of predicting pictures that you might want if you wanted to use the symbols. There are symbols there. So maybe I'll pick that one since you can see that there's cheese on it. And you can also import. So if you hit more symbols, you can search more symbols, but you can also import a image. So if you come to edit, you can see it gives you options to choose a symbol, choose a picture, or take a picture. So you can have either gone on the internet and screenshotted a photo, or you could take a photo if it's something that's specific to the person. This is another great example, like if you're doing family members or pets, where you would want to take a picture of their actual family member or their actual pet. I'll come out of there. So once you have made your changes and you feel good about it, you can hit done. And now when I select that button,
cheeseburger,
it says cheeseburger. It also has a lot of different options. We'll go back to the home screen and we'll clear our message. If you wanted to make changes to the background, so I'm already in voices. So this is your home for settings, and there's a lot of different changes that you can make. So again, you can really individualize the system for the person. So let's say the appearance, you could come in and you could change the size of the message window. You can also turn show message off. You can change the grid size easily. So if I wanted to go bigger, I could do that or come back. Be careful with changing grid size a lot. We always want to try to just start as big as possible. And then instead of starting small and getting bigger and bigger, because it will, if you look here, if I start with something like this, the buttons are a lot bigger and there's a lot less on the screen, which may seem easier. But if the person starts to, you know, need a lot more vocabulary when we come back to a bigger screen, you can see that it actually changes the location of those buttons. And that can get really confusing for an AAC user. So if you can start bigger with a grid size, that's really good. But you can come in and you can change the background color, and they have tons of options. So you could do somebody's favorite color, or if they have, you know, cortical visual impairment and they need certain color combinations, this is where you can kind of come and really individualize that to fit their specific needs. So the system has, you know, you can change skin tone of the symbols to match the person, which is really great. Again, you can come and you can do different voices. So it has a ton. And if you press here, you can change the voice personalization. So you can make it higher pitched or deeper. And that's really fun when the person is kind of first getting their device to kind of play around with these things and let them listen, because it is important that they feel like it represents their voice or it's a voice that they enjoy listening to. So these are all the different voice options, and all of these come with the app. They're not, you don't have to pay anything additional. And there's even more, and you could even change the accent. So maybe they want an Australian accent or an English accent. You are able to do that. So a lot of good options to individualize. And that is pretty much it, unless there's a question or something specific anybody wants to see. That's just kind of an overview of Proloquo2go.
All right, so thank you for that great presentation, Sam. I think that was really well done. As Sam just asked for, if anyone has any questions in the chat, feel free to either unmute yourself and ask them or type them in the Zoom chat. In the meantime, I'm going to link our survey in the Zoom chat. It would also be helpful for us if you all could take a moment to complete it. So just gonna wait here for questions or comments. All right, we have, looks like we have Jay just saying this was great, thank you. And we also have Julie saying great job, great information. So thank you both for joining us. I agree, I think it was a great presentation as well. We have Felicia in the chat saying thank you. Thank you for joining us. I've linked our survey in the chat. So Sonia also saying great job. Thank you. Thank you, Sonia. So our survey is in the chat. If anyone in attendance could please just take a moment to complete us, that would be, complete it. That would be very helpful for us. We have Sherry Wood saying thank you for the great information. We also have Tammy saying good job, Sam. Thank you. I'm getting a lot of love in the chat today.
Yeah, thank you guys. Makes me feel good.
All right, and Sam has also put on screen, looks like, the overview of the app. We have the price, features, device, languages, and accessibility. So if anyone's curious, you know, take a screenshot, but also I'm sure if you have any questions, you can email Sam. And can you just really quickly just give your email, Sam?
Yeah, here, and then I'll also throw it in the chat.
Beautiful.
And we do have iPads available to loan. So if it's something that you're interested in using for a client or a prospective user, you just want to try it out and see it for yourself, you are welcome to loan an iPad to try it out.
All right, I think that that's great. So this is going to be our last call for questions. Speak now, forever hold your peace. Going once. Going twice. All right, looks like we have no takers. So just a reminder that we do these AT for all calls every Thursday at 11:30. So please join us at the same link, same information next week for a similar conversation. And with that being said, I think that that's all we have for today's lesson. So thank you again all for joining us. I hope that you enjoy your long weekend and stay safe.
Thank you guys.